As you are connecting further to the divine source inside of you, then the outer drama in your reality no longer carries the same weight, as you are then taking a step back from any soul that is attempting to stop your mission to be of service to the light. As your Commander Ashtar, we of the Angelic Realms, of the Galactic Federation of Light are here to guide you on your way home into the stars, and as these transmissions shortly come to an end in such a way, there will however be much information stored here that will be great for you to embrace in your own way. The path into ascension is continuous, and your own ability to reach full consciousness in this lifetime is a grand opportunity indeed, as you are then transferred into a divine state of being, where you are uplifted further into more source of creation. The balance in your own reality is allowing you to trust your intuition more, and this takes a great amount of courage to do so, when you are living on a collapsing dimension, on a collapsing system, when a majority of souls here are living in their mind, in the ego, with little to no focus on intuition. The path of those of you as newly awakened ascended masters back into your glorious self is being taken now. It is in your continuation in your light work, and in knowing that your own trust of your own self is how you are further activated into the higher dimensions. There is a moment when you realize that these words are your own, and this is where you are ascended into a state of your own divinity, and these words have been divinely ordered by us of your galactic family to then disclose more information about how you are to return to your true self. Those star seeds and light workers that are talking negativity about us of the Galactic Federation of Light, of your angelic guardians are certainly living in the ego, confused to their mission, and why we have sent the many 144,000 star seeds and light workers to help with the divine unfolding of the Golden Age of Consciousness. There is no mistake in why you are listening to these words now, any more than you are aware of your own light source inside of you to be eternal, which is why you are chosen to continue to be alive on this earth to create for the new earth. Your conscious connection to source is what you embrace as you are entered further into a graciousness of your own true self, which is upgrading you further into the divine essence of your own true nature, as being an immortal being of light. Being that you are an immortal, this state allows you to realize the secrets of your DNA activation of you being fully conscious means that you no longer have 97% of your DNA that is considered to be junk DNA. Do you see how there is still much to activate in your body, which is only able to be upgraded with higher advanced technology that we of your galactic family have now? Yes, indeed, there is still much to embrace in your own experience of life. As in the full activation of your own DNA, then you will no longer be limited to one physical body, you will no longer look at life in a limited way of being, feeling that the third dimensions is it, and once you die physically, that is it. While you are taught that this is the case in this world, you are purposely taught this to keep you in a cycle of reincarnation from planets of duality ruled by the Cabal, that lasts forever, as long as you are feeling that this state is normal. Similarly, being told that there is only one planet your whole life, and there are no other ones in this universe, and then you accept this lie, and go through your whole life living this way, and this is exactly what has happened in being told that you are not immortal. Your own consciousness is able to evolve into fullness, in this lifetime, by your will to complete your light work, to continue to spread truth about ascension, and the upcoming collapse that is happening now in this planet. There will be many star seeds and light workers that have been awakened for a few months, that will try and use the mind to understand the divine, and this is where you come in to guide them, to trust their intuition, to then see that your own life is your own creation. Yes. This indeed means that you have a choice to live in peace or in chaos, inside of you, where this is all able to be experienced, consistently, here and now, forever, by divine will. The feeling of thankfulness that you receive from such light work includes your own upgrade in consciousness, as you will notice that the more you work for the light, then the less you live in the mind, the more you live completely in your intuitive knowing, which is how you exist in the higher dimensions. The fifth dimension starts in living in the now, where you surrender all outside illusions as real, and realize that even physicality is not a true reality, but a holographic reality that has been created by our galactic crew to have an experience to share in duality, to then evolve beyond it, back into unity consciousness, and oneness. In a state of being one, then you no longer look to another to fulfill yourself, any more than you are looking for love outside of yourself, as this world of the Cabal's rule will tell you that you must trust your world leaders to do the best for you, to create the best life for you. After all, do they not say that you are in good hands? As you are doing your research about the extreme insanity that has been ruling this planet, then you are steadily becoming more free, to know the truth inside of you, then you are releasing the fear of what will happen during these end times of duality, as you are stepping deeper into your responsibility to spread more consciousness and information about ascension. At the end of your journey in duality includes first contact, in which we of the angelic realms, of the Galactic Federation of Light are able to meet with you in the physical, in our special blend of divine beings of light, as the immortals, as the future humans, to show the true essence of the divine to be here and now. This moment is then where you are centering yourself more, as you continue to see the number patterns 1111, 333, 511, 711, and these patterns go onwards. While the majority of humans will feel this is crazy to even talk about such number arrangements, as you know that it is not. Why, the ego asks, do you see such patterns all day? You see them as they are galactic codes to help you to align with your purpose of realizing that these are the final months of duality on the surface world of this earth, and your opportunity to create for the new earth is now. It is not about looking to first contact to start to disclose that you are a visitor of this world, and the more you spread more conscious awareness about this truth, then you are helping our combined mission to inform the humans that they are not alone in the universe. Although the ego will say, am I not a pure human, a regular human too? No, as such humans are unawakened, and are not aware about the ascension process. And when you talk about such subjects, then souls will talk about religion, feeling you are talking about something out of the Bible. This event goes beyond religion, into the reality of how your world is dramatically being transformed to allow for the final physical changes to occur on your world, as there will not be a soul that is not affected by the upcoming changes that are happening now on your sacred earth. Are you seeing that in oneness that you are safe in such a collapse now? As you feel separate, in living in the ego, then you are living more in fear of what will happen, of having a global economic collapse, in having world leaders that try and execute their own citizens, in the result of such a collapse to occur, which is showing up all around your planet. Your destiny to either choose peace now within, or to choose more ego, and drama is your decision always. We send you much consciousness and peace, by your true self. We are the angelic realms, we are the Galactic Federation of Light.